What's up, Rich Squad? Welcome back to the channel. It's your boy, Dominic Rich. If you're new around here, consider hitting the subscribe button because I'll be covering the entire 32nd edition of the African Cup of Nations. The 2019 African Cup of Nations is hosted by Egypt and they kickstarted the tournament versus Zimbabwe. Egypt and Zimbabwe were drawn in Group A alongside Uganda and DR Congo, who will kickstart their tournament on match day 2. One thing I noticed about the opening match, the turnout was great. 75,000 plus people in the stadium. Comparing to the Copa America and the Gold Cup, damn, the African nations are showing them up. As for head-to-head, this was the 15th meeting between Egypt and Zimbabwe, with Egypt winning 9, 4 games ending in draws, and Zimbabwe only picking up 2 wins back in 1992 and 1995. Note guys, VAR will not be used in the group phase and the round of 16 of the African Cup of Nations, but it will be introduced in the quarterfinals of the tournament. So for the opening match of the 2019 African Cup of Nations, Egypt 1, Zimbabwe 0. It was a very good start to the tournament. If all the games are gonna be like this, the AFCON is the tournament to watch. Not the Gold Cup, not the Copa America, but the African Cup of Nations. I'll still be watching the Gold Cup and the Copa America though. The game's only goal was scored by Trezeguet in the 41st minute, and to me, he is my man of the match. For the host Egypt, Javier Aguirre played a 4-2-3-1 formation with El Shenouari in goal, El Mohamedi, Alaa, Hegazi, and Ashraf at the back. In the number 6 roles, we had Hamed and El Neni. Ahead of those two, we had Mohamed Salah on the right wing, Trezeguet on the left, and Saeed in the middle, with Mohsen the lone man up top. Off the bench, we saw Amer Wada, Imad, and Soliman. For Sunday Chidzwamba, he played a 4-4-2 formation, with Sibanda in goal, who had to go off injured and was replaced by the substitute goalkeeper. In the defense, we had Darikwa at right back and Lunga at left back. In the center back positions, we had Hadebe and Modimu. If I ever cover a Madagascan game, I will not be doing the lineup for that team, seriously. But let's continue. In the middle of the field, we had Marvelous Nakamba and Munetsi. On the wings, the captain Masuna and Billiat, who was one of the best players on the day. Up top, we had Mushekwi and Karuru. Off the bench, we saw Chawapiwa, Rusiki, and the substitute goalkeeper Chipazizi. For the first 20 minutes, it was all Egypt. I think Zimbabwe started the game very nervously, and Salah, Mohsen, and Trezeguet really kept the Zimbabwean defenders and the goalkeeper Sibanda busy. Zimbabwe did have a few attacks as well, but nothing too incisive to trouble the Egyptian defense. For Zimbabwe, Billiat was causing quite a bit of trouble on the left flank, but it was Egypt who was enjoying the bulk of the possession, and I think they got behind that Zimbabwean defense way too easy, but was unable to take any of their early chances. From the 25th to the 30th minute, Zimbabwe enjoyed some possession, but they were unable to muster up anything threatening. Salah had another good chance, saved by Sibanda, and then the two teams took a well-deserved water break because of the sweltering heat in Cairo. It was very, very hot. After the water break, Hegazi picked up a nose injury after a clash of heads. And then it was Zimbabwe's turn to give Egypt a scare when a free kick saw Billiat run behind, but the goalkeeper El Shenouari was equal to the task. That was some clever stuff by Billiat and company. This guy Billiat was quite impressive in the game. I love the look of him. He plays in South Africa for Kaizer Chiefs. I have seen him on FIFA, but this was the first time I'm seeing him live in a game. And I was quite impressed. And just as I began to say that Zimbabwe were looking dangerous in the game, they conceded. I was even surprised that it took Egypt that long to score. It was a nice link-up play between Trezeguet and Ashraf on the left flank. And when Trezeguet got the ball left, he cut in from the left, maneuvered himself around the Zimbabwean defenders, and got a really nice shot off to beat Sibanda at his far post. Egypt opened the scoring, and that goal turned out to be the only goal of the game. Egypt took a well-deserved lead because they were teasing for the entire first half. Just before the halftime break, Mohamed Salah had another shot, but he did not score. At halftime, with the score being 1-0, I think Zimbabwe represented themselves really well because of the unrelenting pressure that Egypt brought, and Zimbabwe just soaked that up. Sibanda was really good in goal. No wonder he got injured and had to go off later. Coming back for the second half, Egypt continued to apply the high press. We had Tarek Amid with a really good shot saved by Sebanda and another shot by Salah right after that easily saved. Zimbabwe were under immense pressure. It was very high octane stuff. The game was played at a very, very good pace. I like it. And if this is how most of the African Cup of Nations matches are gonna be, man, we are in for something this summer. Zimbabwe had a free kick in the 55th minute, and that was their prime chance to level things, but they put it wide. One of the major talking points in the game came in the 59th minute when Mohsen injured the Zimbabwean goalkeeper Sebanda, who had to later go off. Mohsen was in on goal, he got a touch off, the ball was saved by Sebanda, and his follow-through injured the goalkeeper. I don't think Mohsen did it on purpose, it was just part of the game. Just after that, Mohsen went off and Suleiman came on. And the commentator was saying that this guy Suleiman is a danger man. I didn't really see that in the game, but we shall see as the tournament progresses. I thought they looked very, very solid in the back, and Zimbabwe wasn't able to stitch together anything creative enough to threaten them. At that point in the game, I was saying to myself, Trezeguet looks the best player on the field, even ahead of Mohamed Salah. Billiot also looked good as well. Look for this guy Billiot in the remaining matches, man. He is a freaking good player. Goalkeeper Sebanda tried to continue, but the amount of saves he had to make, they had to substitute him. And at that point, I was saying, with a new goalkeeper coming on, that might spell disaster for Zimbabwe. They might concede, because you know when one goalkeeper is in the game and he's doing well, and when a new one comes on, oh man, he might not be up to speed with things in the game. He might not be up to the tempo of the game, and you know what happens, guys. But it wasn't so. He was also good when tested by the Egyptians. For the last 10 minutes of the game, Zimbabwe began to up the tempo, and they were troubling the Egyptian defenders a bit. Billiot looked really good again, man. This guy, I'm talking about this guy a lot because he was good in the game. Salah had a shot saved by the substitute goalkeeper, and then Zimbabwe had a header which went over the bar. They missed their chance to equalize. The game ended 1-0 in favor of the host Egypt, but all in all, it was a respectable performance by Zimbabwe. They should walk away from this fixture with their heads held high. But in summary, it was Egypt's quality that separated the two teams. Zimbabwe promised, but they lacked the end product. As for stats in this game, Egypt had 16 shots at goal with 9 on target. They had 60% of the possession, 534 passes with an 81% pass completion. They committed 11 fouls. It was a very, very clean game with only one yellow card shown to a Zimbabwean player. For Zimbabwe, they had 11 shots at goal, 2 on target. They had 40% of the possession, 364 passes, 75% pass accuracy, 10 fouls committed, 1 yellow card shown. It was a good performance by Zimbabwe. It just shows you that Egypt has vulnerabilities that they need to fix as the tournament progresses, because when they meet the better teams, they will get punished. Definitely will get punished. Egypt's next game will be versus DR Congo on Wednesday the 26th of June, while Zimbabwe will take on Uganda on the same day. For tomorrow's games, we have Group A fixtures between DR Congo and Uganda. That one will be hard to predict. I did not predict DR Congo to progress from the group, so I'm gonna go for a Uganda win in that game. I'm gonna say a 2-1 win for Uganda. There's also two Group B matches played tomorrow between Nigeria, the team I'm following at the tournament. I picked Nigeria via a random draw. It was not by choice, it was by a random draw. Go check out the video on my channel. Check it out in my African Cup of Nations playlist. They take on the debutants Burundi, and I expect nothing less than a win from Nigeria. So I'm gonna go for a 2-0 win for the Super Eagles here. The other group B match between Guinea and Madagascar. I did predict Madagascar to get out of Group B though. Second place. Very, very gutsy prediction. Either second or third, I can't quite remember right now. In this game, I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw here. A surprise 1-1 draw for the debutants, Madagascar. So guys, share your predictions for tomorrow's matches in the comment section down below. If you're new around here, consider hitting the subscribe button, smash the thumbs up button, and in the comment section down below, let me know who you think will win the African Cup of Nations. Also guys, I will not be doing detailed match analysis for every single game. I will be choosing one game and then I will be doing summaries for the rest, but I will be trying to watch as many games as possible. I really like the timing of the games. Early on in the day does not conflict with Copa America nor the Gold Cup matches. So guys, I'm your boy Dominic Rich, and until tomorrow, I like to say peace out. Rich Squad!